18052, Unit 3B, Aromaticity, Video Lecture 3. I am Dr. Devang R. Pandya from Department of Chemistry, St. Javier's College, Autonomous, Ahmedabad, 09. Well, in previous lecture, we have discussed the different characteristics to prove the aromaticity of organic compound, especially cyclic compound. And with the primary member of cyclic structure, cyclopropanyl cation and anion, through HMO calculation, we proved whether one compound is aromatic or anti-aromatic. In the addition of that, we have NMR spectra. The chemical shift of cyclopropanyl anion, hydrogen will be lower delta value, and therefore the ring cannot be aromatic, and thus cyclopropanyl anion is anti-aromatic. So the first primary member of cyclic compound through HMO calculation and using NMR, we can prove that cyclopropanyl cation, here it is, cyclopropanyl anion is anti-aromatic. On the other hand, cyclopropanyl cation is aromatic. So for aromaticity, planar structure is required, conjugated double bond system is required, all carbon in the structure must be of sp2 hybridization. Moreover, it should follow Huckel's rule for n plus 2 pi electron system. Moreover, through NMR we can prove the aromaticity, and HMO calculation also prove resonance stability is another factor to prove the aromatic character of these compounds. Here next example is cyclopentadienyl anion. We need to prove it is aromatic, and cyclopentadienyl cation is anti-aromatic. Cyclopentadienyl anion is a 6 electron system. Here you can see that this is the structure of cyclopentadiene. In cyclopentadiene, 2 and 2, 4 pi electron is there, and this carbon is sp3 hybridized. So out of this carbon, if we substitute one proton using base, in the presence of base, when one proton is substituted from this cyclopentadiene, we're going to get cyclopentadienide. That is the anion, because the proton leaving the pair of electron on carbon live as a proton, and therefore there is electron excess electron occupy on the carbon, and it become carb anion. The cyclopentadienyl anion has 2 pi bonds, 4 electrons, and one, that is 4 electron of this 2 pi bond, and one is of this lone pair of electron that is available on the 5th carb anion, makes it 6 electron in the MO. Now Huckel's rule, according to Huckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electrons are present where n is equal to 1 in cyclopentadienide ion, and therefore it is aromatic compound. So here with substitution of proton converting into anion, cyclopentadienyl anion, we can prove that it has 6 pi electro cloud, sectet is complete, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and according to Huckel's rule, it will follow 4n plus 2 pi electron rule, and as a result, it is aromatic in nature. Now this sp3 hybridized carbon converted into sp2 hybridized carbon, so it got a planar structure, a conjugation, and Huckel's rule, all aromatic characteristic prove that this compound is aromatic in nature. Now resonance structure, we have the resonance structure of this cyclopentadienyl anion. So here the lone pair electron which is shifted over here. So this electro cloud will shift it over here, and that way we are going to get this 5 structure. 6th structure is the resonance hybrid of this all resonating structure of cyclopentadienyl anion, and that prove that more the resonating structure, more would be the resonance energy, more would be the stability, and that is how we can prove the aromatic character of cyclopentadienyl anion through resonance and stabilization. The cyclopentadienyl ion is represented as structure 6 as a resonating hybrid of the 5 resonating structure of cyclopentadienide ion. Resonance in this ion is greater than in the pyrrole, thiophene and furan, which is almost considered as an aromatic heterocyclic compound. Since all 5, 1 to 5 forms are equivalent, they are having more stability. Resonance energy for this structure 6, that is resonating hybrid, has been estimated between 24 to 27 kilocalorie per mole. It is diatropic and gives electrophilic substitution readily. Therefore, it is aromatic in nature. One more parameter, that if a compound is diatropic and if it undergo electrophilic substitution rapidly, then also it is considered as an aromatic compound. And the resonating energy also prove, which is closer to the benzene, 36 kilocalorie per mole, and that is why it is also considered as an aromatic compound. Now this is the MO diagram of the cyclopentadienyl anion. Here you can see that all the electrons are paired up in lower energy, that is BMO. So the chemical shift of all proton of cyclopentadienyl anion has higher value and have diamagnetic in nature, because all the electrons are paired up. It is diamagnetic in nature. Ring current, which is evidence of deshielding effect of the proton, and therefore cyclopentadienyl is aromatic. Now NMR is the another factor to prove the aromatic character of the compound, where chemical shift of the protons is at higher value, delta value. This is delta, not end, typological mistake. And it is diamagnetic in nature. Another parameter is the ring current, which is the evidence of deshielding. So the aromatic compound have proton which are deshielding in nature. They should be outside of the ring, and therefore this compound is considered as an aromatic. So deshielding protons presence is another evidence of the aromatic character of the cyclic compound, that is noticed in the cyclopentadienyl anion, and that is why it is aromatic in nature. Cyclopentadienyl cation. Now here we have sp3 hybridized carbon of cyclopentadiene, and the hydrogen depart by taking the bond pair electron as a hydride rather than a proton. So there should be a deficiency of electron on this carbon, which give rise to this positive charge. And now this compound turn into cyclopentadienyl cation. Cyclopentadienyl cation contains 2 pi bonds, that is this one and this one. So total 4 pi electrons is there. According to Huckel's rule, cyclopentadienyl cation has 4 pi electrons. So it follow that rule or fits into 4n pi electron system, where n is equal to 1, and that is the condition according to Huckel's rules for anti-aromaticity. So we can prove that this compound have 4 pi electron, and therefore it has 4n pi electron according to Huckel's calculation, and it is anti-aromatic in nature. So all the carbons are sp2 hybridized, planar system is there, conjugation is there, but not fully conjugation. Resonance structures are available as well, but yet because it will not follow Huckel's rule 4n plus 2 pi. Instead, it will follow 4n pi electron system. It is anti-aromatic in nature. So here that resonating structures are there. The MO diagram, where you can see that in BMO, this lowest energy is paired up, but this little higher energy has two unpaired electrons. So dielectron unpaired present into the compound. Although it have a 5 resonating structure and 6th one is the resonating hybrid, this compound is not aromatic, but it is anti-aromatic. Why it is so? The cyclopentadienyl cation is represented as the structure 6 as a resonating hybrid, and resonance in this ion is less, and so the resonating energy is also less. As far as NMR spectra is concerned, the chemical shift of the protons present into this 1, 2, 3 and 4 carbon of the cyclopentadienyl cation has value of delta with the lower shift, and it is unpaired electron, so paramagnetic in nature, and therefore paramagnetic ring current is there, which also prove that this compound is anti-aromatic. Therefore, cyclopentadienyl cation is anti-aromatic. Now, cycloheptatetraene cation is more stable than cycloheptatetraenyl anion. Or in other way, the question would be asked, prove tropylium cation is aromatic, but cycloheptatetraene is non-aromatic. So here is the tropylium ion. How we can obtain? So this is sp3 hybridized carbon, 7 sectate heptagon polygon is there, 1, 2, 3 pi electron, that is 6 pi electro cloud is there, but this carbon is sp3 hybridized. So this compound is not aromatic, but if we substitute one hydrogen and that hydrogen taking the bond pair electron as a hydride, not proton, then it will create deficiency on this carbon. As a result, we have positive charge on that carbon. So now this turns into tropylium ion or cycloheptatetraenyl cation. According to Huckel's rule, tropylium ion is cyclic and planar compound. It contains 3 pi bonds and 6 pi electrons. 3 pi bond, 1, 2 and 3, and 6 pi electro cloud. It obeys Huckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electron, where n is equal to 1, and therefore tropylium ion or cycloheptatetraenyl cation is aromatic in nature. Here you can see the resonating structure of the compound, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the H structure is the resonating hybrid of this cycloheptatetraenyl cation. There are 7 resonance structures of tropylium ion which make it more stable, and more the resonating structure, more the resonance energy, more the stability of the compound. The 6 double bond electrons of the tropylium overlap with the empty orbital on the 7th carbon, and there is a sectate. So this 7th carbon doesn't contain electrons. So these 3, 1, 2 and 3, that is 6 pi electron, 6 double bond electrons of tropylium overlap with the empty orbital on the 7th carbon, and that way it is going to form the sectate of electrons covering 7th carbon. This 7th carbon is covered by this 6 pi electron and is quite stable compound. Therefore, tropylium ion is considered as aromatic. And the sp2 hybridized structure, planar geometry, complete conjugation, follow 4n plus 2 pi electron, NMR shift, of the protons at higher delta ppm and more resonating structure, more resonance energy, 6 pi electro cloud will cover the 7th carbon and form the sextet, gives quite stable arrangement of this resonating form, and therefore tropolium ion is considered as an aromatic. Now if we study the MO diagram, you can see that all the electrons on the BMO is paired up electron in this cyclohepta tetranyl cation or tropolium cation. If we will substitute this compound by bromine, so whether it undergo electrophilic substitution or not, tropolium bromide, which could be completely covalent if the electrons of the bromine were sufficiently attracted to the ring, it is actually an ionic compound. It's going to form ionic compound, that is, instead of covalent in nature, it has electrostatic attraction, so it's going to form tropolium bromide. Thus, tropolium bromide ion is also aromatic because it's not going to bound the carbon, so the conjugation of the sextet will retain because of this stable electrostatic attraction between this compound and a bromine. So tropolium bromide, which is ionic in nature, is an aromatic compound. Now cycloheptatetranyl anion, so negative charge. So here also, this is sp3 hybridized carbon in cycloheptatetraene, and when the sp3 hybridized carbon, one of the proton instead of hydride, proton giving the bond pair electron to the carbon, remove as a proton, excess of electron occupy on this carbon. So now 1, 2, 3, that is 6 pi, and 2 of this lone pair, 7 and 8 electrons are there. These 2 lone pair electron will occupy into ABMO, if we will see the MO diagram. So bond pair electrons, BMO is completely filled, and this excess of lone pair will occupy into antibonding molecular orbital, and that is why it will going to oppose the aromatic character of this compound. Although all the carbons are sp2 hybridized, planar geometry, complete conjugation of electron system, pi electron system, delocalized electron system, yet according to Huckel's rule, it is considered as an anti-aromatic. Let's see how it is. Cycloheptatetranyl anion has 3 double bonds, that is 6 electrons, 1, 2 and 3, that is 3 into 2, 6 pi electrons, and a lone pair electron on the as a carbanion. This is carbanion. Thus, it has 8 electrons in the MO. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. That 8 electrons, so it does not obey Huckel's rule, but it fits into 4n pi electron system where n is equal to 2, and therefore this compound is anti-aromatic in nature. In sharp contrast to cyclopentadiene, it is cycloheptatetraene which has no usual acidity. This would be hard to explain without the aromatic sextet theory, since on the basis of resonance forms or a simple consideration of orbital overlaps, cycloheptatetranyl anion should be as stable as the cyclopentadienyl anion. While the cycloheptatetranyl anion has been prepared in solution, it is less stable compared to cyclopentadienyl anion and tropolium ion. Thus, cycloheptatetranyl anion is anti-aromatic and less stable compound. Now, next question, that is to explain benzene is aromatic, but its isomer, fulvene, is non-aromatic. Now, aromaticity of benzene is well known, so I do not need to explain much into that. Huckel's rule, benzene is cyclic, planar, unsaturated, completely conjugated system of hydrocarbon. All carbons are sp2 hybridized and there are three alternate bonds. So it has 6 pi electrons in the MO. And you can see that all the 6 pi occupy into the BMO. And it obey Huckel's rule of 4n plus 2 pi electron system where n is equal to 1. As far as resonance energy is concerned, it has fair enough resonance energy as 36 kilocalorie per mole. And therefore, benzene is going to give us a stable resonating hybrid structure. And it is considered as an aromatic. Therefore, no unpaired electron in MO. Therefore, benzene has diamagnetic ring current and it is aromatic. As far as NMO spectra of benzene is concerned, chemical shift of all equivalent proton has higher delta value, that is greater than 7 ppm. That also proves that all the protons are deshielded, which confirm the aromatic character of the benzene. On the other hand, if we have the isomeric form of benzene, that is fulvene, it is non-aromatic. I am not saying not aromatic or I am not saying anti-aromatic. It is non-aromatic. Now there is a condition for non-aromaticity as well. In the fulvene you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, all 6 carbon is sp2 hybridized. Fulvene is 5 membered cyclic ring with one exocyclic double bond. This is exocyclic double bond and is non-planar cyclic compound. Here the planarity get disturbed due to this exocyclic double bond. The planarity is going to be disturbed, otherwise it is fully conjugated, but due to not planarity it is not aromatic and non-aromatic. The exocyclic double bond in fulvene is polar as dipole moment is very high, and because exocyclic double bond is directed towards the cyclic ring. As far as resonance and stabilization is concerned, there are two alternate pi bond in the 5 membered cyclic ring, this one and this one. This which shows the resonance with the exocyclic double bond, that is this one. But due to the non-planarity, resonance energy is very low, that is 13 kilocalorie per mole, which is quite less compared to benzene. Fulvene is less stable and it gives addition reaction instead of substitution reaction, and thus it is non-aromatic. If we'll take the NMR spectra of fulvene, chemical shift of protons of fulvene is found in a normal olefinic region, that is between 4.6 to 5.7 delta ppm. Thus, no NMR signals in the downfield and diamagnetic ring current is absent. And as a result, fulvene is considered as a non-aromatic compound. So this is the comparison between two isomeric forms, benzene and fulvene. Now tropolones, from the structure of tropolone, that is this one, we can say that it contains 7 pi electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 pi electrons, that this is excess of electrons of this one as well, 7 electrons, but oxygen of ketonic group, this one. This oxygen of the ketonic group is more electronegative, so the electrons of the carbon which are attaching to it attracts towards the oxygen. It is pulling group. So according to Huckel's rule, it shows ring aromaticity. This will going to show ring aromaticity. Although it contains 9 resonating structure, but it is unstable. So the value of resonating energy becomes positive. Thus, according to the latest definition of aromaticity, tropelone is non-aromatic. So although it has conjugation, it shows resonance, but resonating structures are less stable. And therefore, according to new definitions of the aromaticity, it is considered as non-aromatic compound. Now, tropelones. To explain the stability and phenolic behavior of the above and anionic structure proposed. However, later it was realized that the complete separation of the charge will make the structure unstable. The dipole moment of the compound is 4.3 d, which is higher for the simple compound. This compound do show some aromatic character, but at the same time the separation of the charge not complete x-rays shows that on the bond length are not of same length, and the compound was neither aromatic nor anti-aromatic and called as non-aromatic in the nature. Now, dianion of pentylene is more stable than pentylene. So this is a comparison between pentylene and dianion of pentylene, and we need to prove that dianion of pentylene is more stable or aromatic compared to pentylene itself. So according to Huckel's rule, pentylene is bicyclic hydrocarbon containing four double bonds, 1, 2, 3, and 4 double bonds, and 8 pi electrons, which does not obey Huckel's rule. So according to Huckel's rule, it is not considered as aromatic, so it is non-aromatic in nature. Molecular orbital calculation shows that pentylene is unstable. Here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons are there in BMO. That is 1, 2, 3, 5 bond. And this 1 pi bond which going to enter into NBMO, non-bonding molecular orbital. So it does not have diamagnetic ring current but have paramagnetic ring current. So pentylene has not been prepared, but hexaphenyl and 1,3,5 tritert-butyl derivatives are known. The former is air sensitive in solution, and pentylene and its methyl and dimethyl derivatives have been formed in solution, but they dimerize before they can be isolated. Many other attempts to prepare this system has been failed. This is pentylene dianion, and we need to prove that this is aromatic and more stable. If two electrons are added to pentylene, its stable dianion results. So 1, 2, 3, 4 pi electron and 2 more. That means 10 electron. So according to Huckel's rule, pentylene dianion has 4 double bond and 2 more extra electron, total 10 electrons, which make it aromatic and stable according to Huckel's rule, and it follow 4n plus 2 pi electron system where n is equal to 2, total 10 pi electron. It can be concluded that an aromatic system of electron will be spread over two rings only, and if 10 electrons are available for aromaticity, the for pentylene dianion n is equal to 8, and therefore there are 8 orbitals and 10 electrons and all are paired. Thus it produces diamagnetic ring current and become more stable and aromatic in nature. Here you can see that all the electrons are paired up in BMO, and those which were unpaired in NBMO getting 2 extra electron, they can also get paired up. So dielectric ring current is going to be produced, diamagnetic ring current is produced, and it become more stable. So this much is enough from my side in this lecture. When we meet in the next lecture, we are going to discuss more compound anti-aromaticity and homoaromaticity, and annulenes, different type of annulenes as well.